Welcome to SAR Learning Center. In this video, we are going to see microcontroller interfacing. Here, this is a 8051 microcontroller. First, we are going to write a program to generate a square wave using DAC directly interfaced to the port of 8051. Here, I am using Kale software to execute the 8051 program. First, I am going to explain how to create a project in this Kale software. First, we are going to click project button. Under this project button, this is the new vision project. Creating this one, I create a new project here. My project title is the Square Wave. Project title is Square. Save our project. This I already available. Just replace it. Okay. Next, I am going to search the which type of microcontroller we are going to use. 8051. This 8051 is CAD and design system is there, and lot of companies processors are available in this search button. I am choosing this Intel 8051 for our simulation. This is our project. This is not necessary, that's why I click on the no here. Next, I am going to click the file. You create a new project file. This is the project file. I am going to save this project. First, I am going to save as the, this is the Square Wave .asm. Because I am going to write a program in assembly language. Save. Okay. Next, I am going to integrate the Square Wave project file into this here. Right click this one, manage project items. This is manage project items. In this manage project item, I am going to add the files. My project file size name is Square Wave. This is the ASM file. This is squarewave.asm. Now, just click this one and add this one. After that, we are going to click the OK. Now we are going to see, this is the target one, this target one, under this target one, source group one is there. Under the source group, our squarewave.asm file is available. Now, I am going to write our program. This is our program to generate the square wave using DAC directly interface to the port of 801. How to generate the square wave signal by using the DAC. Okay, in order to generate the square wave, first the digital data corresponding to the negative maximum is sent to the DAC. Negative maximum is sent to the DAC. And then after that particular time delay, the digital data corresponding to positive maximum, initially we are going to send the negative maximum, after that we are going to send the positive maximum sent to the DAC, and again after the time delay. The process is repeated continuously. The frequency of the square wave is decided by the amount of time delay introduced in between the two voltage levels. Okay, clear? Now I am going to write a program. In this program, I am going to divide it into two parts. One is our main program, another one is for the delay subroutine program. Whenever this main program to call the delay subroutine, that time only the delay subroutines can be run. Okay, now I am going to write the program. First one, move P1 comma hash of 00H. What is the meaning of that one? The P1 is the port number. This P1 is the port number. This port, okay, this is the initialize byte, initialize port 1 as output port. Okay, next, what is the next cell? Again, we are going to write move P1, here we are going to hash of 00H. What is the meaning of that one? we are going to send the digital data to DAC to generate the negative maximum. Send. Digital data to DAC to generate negative maximum. This negative maximum signal is 00H. Next, I am going to call a call of delay function. How much delay we are going to create? This delay can be called for this one. Maintain. This is a separate program. This is a subroutine program. I am going to call our subroutine program. Okay, clear? Maintain output of DAC at negative maximum for half the time period. Okay. What is the next function? Next, we are going to send the data to the DAC to generate the positive maximum. Move P1. Here we are going to send the positive maximum. That's why that value become FFH. Okay, clear? Because of this is a 8 bit. Okay, that's why 0FFH. Okay, next one. Send digital data to DAC to generate maximum, that means it's a positive maximum, that is a positive value, positive maximum. Okay, next. Now also we are going to call the delay. Okay, next. Yes, jump. This program is continuously running, because then only we are going to generate the continuous square wave signal. That's why this is again and again this loop can be executed. This again symbol is, this again is from here. Okay, this is a loop function. That's why this is again and again is jumping function. Again and again this continuous loop can be performed. That's why we are using this yes jump again. Okay, clear? Next we are going to write here delay subroutine program. Okay, now we are going to create a delay. That's why we are going to write a delay subroutine program. Whenever the a call function is calling for the delay, that time this delay loop can be executed. This is a a call delay. This name is mentioned to here. That's why this is directly jumped to here. This delay function is working. Under the delay function, what are the things are the move R1. This is the R1 register. We are going to initiate this R1 register's value become 0FFH. Why we are going to put a 0FFH? Load count value. This is we are going to consider count value in the R1 register. This count value become FFH R1 register. Okay, next move. Next register is R2 register. This R2 register also we are going to initialize 0FFH. That means we are going to load count value in R2 register. Okay. Next, what is going to happen? This value going to check until 0. That's why we are going to use D, J, N, Z. Okay, decrement of jump not equal to 0. Okay, that time that function, this loop function is continuously working until loop 1. Where is the loop 1? This is the loop 1. Okay, until 0 that the loop is executed. This loop is executed. Okay, decrement, this is D for decrement, count R2 register value 1 by 1 until 0. Okay, next we are going to decrement the R1 registers also. R1, this is a loop of 2 until the value, that means the loop can be executed. This is loop 2. Okay. Decrement. Decrement. Count. R1 register value is 1 by 1 until 0. Okay. Now we are going to return RET. Return into the our delay function is return. After finally we are going to end the our assembly language program. We are going to end the our assembly language program. Okay, clear. In here we are going to add one more point here. This is the maintain the output of DAC positive time period. Okay, this is for negative, this is for positive. This is for positive maximum. Positive maximum. Okay, this is our program. Okay, I just zoom it our program for your clear view. This is our program. Look at here. Okay, this program is the main program. This is the delay subroutine program. This is the delay subroutine program. Okay, clear. Now we are going to execute our program in the scale software. First we are going to build our program, build the target F7. Here this is a running of the program, the zero errors and zero warning. What is necessary? We are going to debug our program. Okay, start sub debug our session. Okay, this is a minute. Okay, now we are going to execute our program. Okay, this is a our project window. Here this is a logic analyzer is there. Under this logic analyzer we are going to set up of the port. Our port number is the P1. Our port number is the P1. That's why I mentioned as the P1 port. Just click the enter. Now click the P1 value. This is the signal color. Okay, now this is the display type. Here this is the analog, inbuilt is the analog. Now I am going to change into bit. Close that one. Next, what is the necessary? Before that, I am going to show some peripheral devices. This is the I/O port. Our I/O port is a port 1. This is our port 1. Okay. Next, what is the port time? Okay, this one is enough for this one. That's why I am going to take this one. Parallel port 1. Okay. Next, we are going to execute our program. Okay. This is the function. This is the debug program. Step by step, we are going to execute. We are using the F11 command. Okay. Now I am going to run the program continuously. Okay. This is our program. We are going to execute our program. We are going to get the square wave signal. Just to stop the program. This is the positive maximum. This is the positive maximum. This is the negative maximum. Okay. The positive maximum we are going to mention FFH. In the negative maximum we are going to mention 00H. Look at here, this is the positive maximum. We are going to get the 00 value for the P1 port number and FF for the positive maximum value. Okay, this is the port number variation and depends upon the port number. We are going to we are getting the output at the logic analyzer in this screen. Okay, I am going to see the most. I want to show this more bigger. Now we are going to again start. This is continuously running because we are going to create the again and again loop function. That's why the square wave is generated continuously. This is the waveform generation by using the 8051 microcontroller to interface DAC directly. Okay, to the port of 1. To the port number of 1. Okay. Thank you.